guys, this quick video, we're going to look at just some details on finishing the head and arm choke. It's one of my favourite chokes nowadays. It took me a long time to find out all the details to finish it, and this is just sort of how we get that tap from this position. So if I've managed to get to this head and arm choke position here,
yeah, we're here,
arm around the neck,
head stuck in, ear to ear, and we're controlling the position. The first thing I want to do is I want to circle back into my partner and start to lift their head off the mat. So I can pull, I want to release and pull this arm tighter.
Yeah.
So up here, I circle until we start to turn, and I swim and pull this arm tighter. Okay, from here, I go ear to ear and I drop the weight down. I want to circle back out.
Okay, the next thing I want to do is I want to create pressure going down towards the floor. So my shoulder is going to push in towards the mat.
Once I've got it as tight as I possibly can, the next
pressure I'm going to create with my chest, I push my chest in until I get the tap. Okay guys, so what you've got going on is I've got my grip, I'm pushing my shoulder down into the floor, then once I've got that as far as I can, I push my chest across into the back of their shoulder, and that will make that triangle position you have much tighter. Okay guys? So I start in my head and arm choke position here.
First thing is I make sure this is tight and deep around the neck. So I circle into my hip and tighten my arms.
Okay. So my arms open and I use this hand to pull this one in tight.
Okay. Once I've got that tight around the neck, I go ear to ear and go flat with the floor. Shoulder goes down, okay, so I'm pushing the shoulder into her neck. Once that's as tight as I can get it, my chest starts to push in, and that's where I get my tap.
Okay guys, so you're making that triangle position of your arms around her neck, you're pushing pressure this way, making that triangle much smaller, that'll help get the finish with the choke.